Hello there, lovelies. My name is Manaka97, and today I like to call this series Anime News Service whenever I talk about everything and anything new upcoming for anime and anime-based video games. And today, I'm going to be talking about Drake, Alter, and Astolfo being playable characters in Fate Extella Links. Now, if you're new to the Fate series or not sure who these characters are, Drake and Rider Black are the two most popular characters within the Fate series. And for me personally, Drake and Rider Black are the face of the Fate series. Now, this video honestly isn't about who's more popular within the Fate series, but if you're asking me, not only do I love both of these characters, but if you search both of these characters' names up, I guarantee you'll find people that love these two characters more than I do, especially Drake Alter, but we're not going to talk about my waifu listings. But speaking of these two great characters, they are both playable within Fate Extella Link. Now, any information pertaining to the main story for this game is yet unknown, and I mention this because Altair played a big part in the main story, so trying to figure out if she will be making a return or if this game is a continuation is yet unknown. Now, speaking of the original Fate Extella, I've played the game for myself on the PS4, and gameplay-wise, I'm not going to say it's a terrible game, but it's definitely a 5 out of 10 type of game. Not only is the gameplay really average, but another thing I wish they didn't do was take a whole year making a Switch version for it, especially when the new one is coming out in June. And there's still no release date for a Switch version, which is honestly upsetting because it seems like they're going the same route as the vanilla version of Fate Extella and waiting a whole year to make a Switch version. But ending it on a good note, again, Drake and Rider Black are really outstanding characters within the Fate series, and I'm definitely looking forward to them being in the game. But moving on, Yami being a playable character in Black Clover Cork Knight. Now, other than Yami being a playable character, there isn't much I can really touch upon without the screenshot covering it for me, but what I do want to bring up is my opinion towards the game. And I love Black Clover, I don't hate the series or anything, but seeing these screenshots definitely reminds me of Shinobi Strikers. And what I mean by that is, you have this 4v4 battle royale type of gameplay with possibly some capture the flag objectives, but still, for me, this game looks like a complete cluster. And it's not just because it reminds me of Shinobi Strikers either, it's just visually, it doesn't look promising as a whole. And I said this previously, I don't hate Black Clover or this game, it's just for me, I'm worried about this game's expectation. But last but not least, UA High School having interactive environments within Boku no Hero Academia 1's Justice. In December of 2017, Jump Festa announced Bakugo being a playable character alongside two trailers featuring the teaser trailer alongside their gameplay presentation of Deku vs. Bakugo. But released on December 22nd, V-Jump released a magazine of Bakugo going head-to-head with Deku on top of the UA High School. And if you can't tell from the screenshot, yes, wall combat is a gameplay mechanic within 1's Justice. And it's crazy because this isn't just for the story mode like Naruto Storm 4. The wall running slash combat gameplay is for the entire game all around, so if you're wondering if that this is only for story mode purposes, don't fear, because most of the stages in this game have interactive environments with air combat or fighting on top of buildings. And for the release date for My Hero Academia's 1's Justice is yet to be unknown, but thank you so much for watching, lovelies, I really appreciate it. I'm kind of going through some tough times at the moment, so videos will be delayed from time to time, but I do have two videos planned on my second channel, Manaka97 Anime News, where I talk about everything and anything new upcoming for anime and anime-based news. Definitely give the second channel a look at, because again, two of my most newest videos would be uploaded there, and thank you for checking out my news source. Thank you so much, lovelies, for watching my video, and I'll see you guys next time.